Hello everyone. In the process of learning a subject, the most important and first step is to read the lesson. For the students who find it difficult to read the lesson and for the differently abled, we are introducing audio textbooks. Our state government has provided us with PDF of the textbooks. So let us start reading the lessons. Children, speak up. This is the name of our next lesson in extensive reading of our textbook. Let's start reading the lesson. This is an extract from a speech given by Suen Suzuki, a 13-year-old girl from Canada, on June 11, 1992 at the Earth Summit in Rio de Janeiro. Hello, I am Suen Suzuki, speaking for ECO, the Environmental Children's Organization. We are a group of 12 and 13-year-olds from Canada trying to make a difference. Vanessa Sute, Morgan Gisler, Michelle Quigg and me. We raised all the money ourselves to come 6,000 miles to tell you adults that you must change your ways. I'm here to speak for all future generations to come. I'm here to speak on behalf of all the starving children around the world whose cries go unheard. I am here to speak for the countless animals dying across this planet because they have nowhere left to go. I am afraid to go out in the sun now because of the holes in the ozone. I am afraid to breathe the air because I don't know what chemicals are in it. I used to go fishing in Vanakkar, my hometown, with my dad. Until just a few years ago, we found the fish full of cancers. And now we hear about animals and plants going extinct every day, vanishing every day. In my life, I have dreamt of seeing the great herds of wild animals, jungles and rainforests full of birds and butterflies. But now I wonder if they will even exist for my children to see. Did you have to worry about these things when you were of my age? Here you may be delegates of your governments, business people, organizers, reporters or politicians. But really, you are mothers and fathers, sisters and brothers, aunts and uncles. And all of you are someone's child. I am only a child, yet I know we are all part of a family. 5 billion strong, in fact 30 million species strong, and we all share the same air, water and soil. Borders and governments will never change that. I am only a child, yet I know we are all in this together and should act as one single world towards one single goal. In my anger, I am not blind, and in my fear, I am not afraid to tell the world how I feel. I am only a child, yet I know if all the money spent on war was spent on ending poverty and finding environmental answers, what a wonderful place this earth would be. At school, even in kindergarten, you teach us how to behave in the world. You teach us not to fight with others, to work things out, to respect others, to clean up our mess, not to hurt other creatures, to share, not to be greedy. Then why do you go out and do the things you tell us not to do? Do not forget why you are attending these conferences. You are doing this for your own children. You are deciding what kind of a world we will grow up in. Parents should be able to comfort their children by saying everything is going to be all right. It's not the end of the world. We are doing the best we can. But I don't think you can say that to us anymore. Are we even on your list of priorities? My dad always says, you are what you do, not what you say. Well, what you do makes me cry at night. You grown-ups say you love us, I challenge you. Please make your actions reflect your words. Thank you for listening. Yeah.